Waves of coherent thought radiate from the orb, flooding your mind with strange abstract calculations and mathematical formula. It shines so brightly that you can't look at it for long. Okay. I can't also interact. I can run up right here, though. Too far away. Issue the first unlock command from the console in the Cortex room. Yes. You told me to keep moving. At least the door closed behind me. Seems good. Now, see this. A map of another kind. A living painting of the Cortex's thoughts. Tiber? I will explain what I can if you have questions. Some of these questions are really stupid. It refreshes constantly. Is it changing its mind or checking if the thoughts are still there? Delight blooms across your guide's face. I wonder the same thing. He looks at the air, lips moving, composing his response. I like this guy. I just hope I'm successful. Aratus is standing by the button. Standing by, standing by. So I gotta press here.
All right.
The sphere turns slowly, almost thoughtfully. The glow of the control console pulses with it, warming the palms of your hands. What am I gonna do? Stick this thing in my pocket? You see how big this thing is? Use the control console. You touch the console and the warmth spreads up your arms and into your mind. At the moment of contact, a female voice speaks, visitin, and with a brief stutter, it continues, in the truth, would you like to do? You glance around, seeking the source of the voice, before you realize that it is speaking only in your head, and to you alone. Haha, do I dare? I really want to know stuff, though. Request the exact location. This is all, I don't know. I want to ask, like, these informational-type questions. And then, upon failing, do it the right way, right? Or hopefully I can ask all these questions. That'd be great. Ask for basic information on the helmet you found in the bloom. It looks like I can ask all the questions, which is, like, unrealistic because we can only ask this other guy, Genji, one question per person. This helm belongs to the Jemadar Achille. She has been missing for 15 years by the reckoning of your world. It contains a visual record she marked as being of importance. She suggested these images be analyzed. I will do so on your command. Request the exact location of the anchorage. I want to do that too, though. The smooth voice says, the exact coordinates of this station are 12.93476.947-18H57Z. These numbers also helpfully appear in the pale blue light of the control console. You suspect if you had the proper education and context to understand these numbers, you might have a better picture of your location. As it is, they mean nothing to you. Request information on the home planet of the Lascars. A bluish globe seen from a great distance, around which many smaller orbs rotate, appears before your eyes, as if it were floating in front of you. The home of the Lascars is called Ishtrinu. Same. Ask how long have the Lascars been waiting for the ship? Accessing records. Calculating. The Lascars have been waiting for the vessel to take them home for approximately 10,091 of your years. as the Cortex about itself. I am a navigational Cortex. I was manufactured 3,059 cycles ago by the Devabil Combine, with 2,153 cycles remaining. I was brought here through a localized dimensional vortex, which has since collapsed. I am powered by a quantum-tunneled interstitial hovering matrix, the glowing orb you see before you. I interact with both users and appropriate receptacles to provide observed and recorded historical information, starfield tracking and navigation, observation, and essential starport maintenance. I maintain information regarding exactly 1,097,544 star systems, with detailed information on routes between them, including known transdimensional passages. For every world in each of these star systems, I hold detailed images of their night skies and projected daytime star fields. Additionally, I maintain detailed personnel information for this station dating back many centuries. If I ask it about itself again, it's just going to be the same thing exactly, right? Yeah. Examine the station's personnel history. Thousands of records, perhaps tens of thousands, scroll past your eyes, appended with arcane timekeeping, name changes, dates of birth, and death. All the personnel who have ever lived, traveled, or otherwise passed through the anchorage, no matter how brief their stay. The sheer amount of information is overwhelming. Sensing your bewilderment, the smooth voice says, "Certain historical trends can be deduced through analysis of this data, but this does not seem to be your focus. Popular interactions include brief historical overviews of the station, important recent events, and location searches on missing crew members." This is cool. And this is... I'm really enjoying this, but I'm like... This is unrealistic. That this is all taking place in the span of one term. I mean, maybe it's not really speaking in my head, as you would imagine something speaking in real time, but it's like, I'm just wondering, and it's being like completely injected in my head in like a millisecond or something. And like, all of a sudden I know it. Boom! Possible. As for a historical overview on the station. My records extend over 10,000 of your years, inherited from my predecessor in this position. In all this time, the people now calling themselves the Lascars have crewed this station, and pre-existing records suggest that they were here in a more formal military servile capacity before the shipping lanes began to close. The original crew of the station has repopulated the station, and their descendants have grown in number. A number of conflicts have arisen over the years, in particular the five-cycle mutiny, the airlock debacle, and the castaway action. What? The castaway action? It almost sounds like a cast-off thing. Each of these helped define the current power and familial structure of the existing population. The current structure of the population is strongly based on and influenced by the naval hierarchy of their forebears. They await the coming of another ship to close the station properly and bring them home. Now, it's just going to completely repeat. Yeah, so I'm going to stop checking the or going into the again options. Request information on recent occurrences. Approximately 15 years ago, as you measure time, a transdimensional pathway opened to the station. This was the first contact with other sentient life the inhabitants of this station have had in generations. Trade was established. That portal closed recently, but has been replaced with the pathway through which you entered. Well, that explains why we're finding stuff like a spray flash in their little, you know, sealed-off airlock area. They got that in trade. Further information? That's not further information, that's the same information. Review the records for missing personnel. A single Lascar remains unaccounted for. Yeah, that... whatever her name is. Chill... I forget her name. Achille. Geminar Achille passed through the dimensional gateway approximately... The voice pauses as if calculating. 15 years of your time ago, she has not returned. If you have any information on additional personnel not covered by this census, please report immediately to the captain. ask for more information about the missing Jemadar Achille. Jemadar Achille passed through the dimensional portal that opened 15 years ago. You think it would remember? It has to calculate every time. Her mission was to explore and establish potential embassy and trade. She was also to seek out other routes whereby the inhabitants of this station might find passage to their homeworld. Her last transmission contained a report of her investigation of a community known as the Bloom, which apparently existed inside a living creature. She was 28 years of age when she departed. She left behind two sisters, a brother, and a father. Same, right? Yeah. Review something else, then. Because we're done with all that. I await your command. I have the Cortex analyze the data on the helmet. This is probably going to take some time.
I'll remember that.
Processing. One moment. Biological matter has entered some of the helmet's contacts. I will be unable to analyze this object unless the cortex removal process has progressed to the third stage. This will allow me to open the cortex housing and perform a focus scan analysis of the helmet. Oh. Really? I have to remove you just to have you analyze this thing. Well, that's interesting, because I was going to do that anyway. Begin the cortex removal process. Of course. As I note, you are a first-time user. Stage 1 requires you to assemble a pass symbol on the screen before you and pull the lever on the side of the console. A jumble of small, jagged symbols tumble across the screen as if tossed there by a careless hand. Well, this doesn't consume an action. Let's try this. Complain that the process is too complicated. Removal of the cortex is a significant access with potentially hazardous consequences for the anchorage, the voice says pleasantly. As such, the designers of my mind decided that the removal procedure should be undertaken by a user capable of rational thought under pressure. The voice pauses. To put it more simply, you must complete a series of tests in order to gain access to the cortex. I apologize for any inconvenience this may cause you. Yank the lever down without smashing the shape. Yeah, just smash the thing. Assemble the pass symbol. Ask for more information. Do I dare? Do I dare ask for more information? I'm not going to smash the thing. Yank the lever down. Yeah, this is important. I do want more information. I always look for more stuff, you know? 100%. Working swiftly, you compose the small, jagged shapes into a larger, unfamiliar symbol with a series of satisfying clicks. A clunk sounds in the lever's housing, and you pull it down. Clunk. An excellent solution, the voice says warmly. Well done. You didn't have to do anything. The hum beneath the voice changes suddenly. Stage 1 of the removal process has been completed. Your actions must now be verified from the control pad. Please wait. Confirm the first unlock command on the main control panel of the observation deck. Okay, that's for this guy, Aratus, to do. Let's talk to Genji some more. Good thing we don't have to distract anybody else. A moment, please, if you will. If you talk now, I will forget my thinking. Alright, should I just... Genji reaches into the display, spreading his fingers. One of the threads curl around his wrist. I try to follow this... Harekra. How to say? Thought example? To question every thought, yes. To have a flexible mind. He reluctantly removes his hand. The tour must continue. I have much to finish after. Okay, so I'm just gonna wait then. Well, let's just see if he has anything else to say. So keep moving, okay. Oh, how good are you at deception? Throw one of the components to distract the last car from his work. Oh, you are horrible at deception. Who's better? Who is better at deception? It would be better if we knew the plan ahead of time. Is he... Oh, so he can level up after this. Deception. Tiber is very good with deception. Okay, Eritus? You get to do something. You get to annoy this guy.
Yes.
She has to wait. I don't want to mess anything up. Ditto. Wait, no, 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 no. No! No! Oh, crap. Tiber's supposed to go over there. Are we still on Tiber? Damn, I screwed that up. Well, he's close, at least. Yeah, I screwed that up majorly. I forgot it was going. Now see, he trails off and chuckles. You know this door, of course. You came to us from it. Yes. Most illuminating. Can I do an action? Yeah, I just kind of jumped over the railing, I guess. Okay. The small pile of components beside the last car seems to have grown. His repairs are apparently not going well. Okay, throw one of the components to distract the last car from his work. And of course we can get up to 100. You snatch one of them up when his back is turned and toss it over his shoulder. There is a distant clattering. The last car glances at you, confused at the sound, then turns to see what it was. He will not be distracted for long. Unfortunately, our turn is over. Let's catch up with, what's his name? Eritus? Oh, wait, we're on Eritus. Where is he? This is him. Oh, we have a pathing error, apparently.
Here comes the boredom slayer.
Oh, he was underneath the floor. Huh? Okay, so that's its complete movement. I can't press it yet. Damn it. Calistes, however, is on the right level. Have you any questions of the door to your home? He chuckles, clearly expecting none. Yeah, well, you have a few. However many you feel like answering. Huh. Have you ever been to the Bloom? He makes an unfamiliar gesture in the air, a sort of snatching movement as if he has touched something hot. No, and I never will. I belong here. Am needed here. He gestures you along, urging you to follow him. And he's going. Alright, so now we can interact.
Why not?
Hopefully you're good at whatever we have to do. The cleanest screen on the console is displaying an angular symbol composed of many tiny pieces. A button is flashing beside it. Let's just do it like this. Press the stage 1 button while the Lascar is not looking. Yep, we didn't need to study, apparently. You wait until the Lascar is preoccupied and swiftly tap the button. The Lascar looks over at the sound, at your innocent face, and at the now dark screen and button. He frowns. Yes? Can I help you? Way to go. He's way over here. Are you stuck? You can't talk to him? Nope, you can't even run that far. You can run up to here. Here comes the Boredom Slayer. Okay, now. Continue. Issue the second unlock command? Isn't this the third unlock command?
Let's go.
Continue. Stage 2 initialized. Please identify the core locking components from the previous stage. Once you have done so, the casing over error unable to translate title of switch will open. Flip the switch to complete the stage. This doesn't consume an action. What am I supposed to do again? Identify the core locking components from the previous stage. The casing over something, some switch will open. Flip the switch to complete. Ask about the error the Cortex mentioned. You hear a series of clicks in your head. Apologies. A separate intelligence is responsible for error reporting. I am not aware of any errors at this time. Please proceed with the actions required for stage 2. Lore Machinery. Identify the correct symbols from the previous stage. 100%. A flood of symbols streams across the console's tiny screen. At first, none of them look in any way familiar, but as you watch, you recognize a few. They disappear beneath your tapping fingertips with sweet piping pings. A fluttering sound, something like an insect's wings, rises from the console, and the casing pops open. You flick the switch. Stage 2 complete, the voice says with real pleasure. Well done. Your actions in Stage 2 have been sent to the observation deck to be verified. Please wait. Damn it. Confirm the second unlock command. Blah, blah, blah. Calistige. Talk to the guy. Tor. Not have much time. Etc. See this now. A door once used by the most exalted travelers. He shakes his head, smiling. Now, often broken, and room beyond is for storage. He pats the door as if apologizing to it. Tiber. On the monitor, 6 sigils whirl about each other in a dizzying spiral. A button blinks urgently beside it. This is what? Intelligence. ?85%? The Lascar glances up, eyes leaving the monitor. Swift and silent as air, you lean over and press the button. Oh my god, he's out of, like, so much. The Lascar looks back down at the click, frowning again. Touch? He says sternly. You do not respond, and after a moment he returns to his work, eyeing you more often now. You better not need me to do any more stuff like this. Can I talk to him? I could distract him more, but let's... I'd have to take something first. Eretis... He folds his hands, awaiting your questions. Why does the door break so often? Cannot say, he says, grimacing. I wonder this myself. He gestures you along, urging you to follow him.
I'm going.
Continue. Starting to get down to the wire here. Stage 3 initialized. Simply arrange the previously selected symbols into a critical error. Existing syntax is inadequate. The voice says in high, pleading tones, instructions are flawed. User may be unable to Apologies, my recording software crashed. Anyway, instructions are flawed. User may be unable to complete Cortex removal procedure. Maintenance is requested. Repeat, maintenance is requested. After a long pause, the voice resumes, utterly calm. Once this is complete, manually pull the locking cylinder from its housing, rotate it, and insert it back into the console. Warn the Cortex that its instructions were full of errors and missing information. You know, I wonder if it's trying to stop us. You know, if it's programmed to, you know, instruct us on how to remove it, but it knows it should not be removed, so it's trying to stop us, that kind of thing, by inserting errors. You think you smell burning plastic, molten metal. Then the voice speaks. I am not aware of any errors, it whispers hoarsely. Complete the stage to the best of your ability. If you are unable to do so, I will not be able to release the Cortex as requested. My apologies. The whispers fall silent. Lore machinery. Try to figure out what you're supposed to do. Bereft of any useful instructions, you study the sigils rotating on the screen. All of them are moving except the one in the upper left corner, the original shape assembled in stage 1. On a whim, you arrange the remaining sigils into a frame surrounding that shape. Excellent work, the voice says. I've never seen it done faster. Yeah, well, I had 100%, so... Yeah. Please wait. Your actions in stage 3 must be verified. Oh, damn it. Waiting. He folds his hands, awaiting your questions. I have to do something? What if your ship comes? Would they come through this door? He opens his mouth, shuts it, gives the door a long, worried look. He gazes up at the seldom-used door, at the grime gathering along the top rim of the track. You are right, he says at last. I see this door as a symbol, how the anchorage changed over our lifetimes. But perhaps I forgot the importance of its function. I will see to its repair. He nods thankfully at you and motions to follow him. I just want to see... Yeah, that's horrible. 10%. Oh. Crap. This is what we need. I can't give it to him. I can't save. He's out of intellect. He only has strength at this point.
Absolutely.
Quick fingers and stealth. Who else has quick fingers and stealth? Or maybe if I analyze his actions, I get a bonus to doing that. Unfortunately, it takes up an action. Let me just see. I'm not in. I don't want to be there. Yeah, that's really it. I mean, no one has an inability in it. Tiber's the best at it. I'm gonna try this. Oh, one intellect. Or I'll try this. Throw another of the components to distract the Lascar from his work. No. How about not?
Why not?
Study the Lascar's movements to get a better sense of when he's not paying attention to the controls. You observe him for a handful of broken moments. He divides his attention between his repairs and the buttons to his immediate right and left. There's something else about his movements, something potentially useful, but you can't quite catch what it is. Is that perception?
Why not?
Damn it. I'm gonna have to send Calisthenes over there.